More than 10 girls from St. Mary's Girls Runda in Kiambu were reported missing on Saturday morning after their attempt to burn the school was discovered on Friday night, prompting them out of school compound. Police, parents and school management have been trying to comb neighborhoods and to trace the missing girls. 10 other girls were apprehended and have been interrogated by police on what really transpired. The school has been closed indefinitely as parents and teachers make frantic efforts to try and trace the missing girls who they fear could be in danger.
Whoever will be found culpable as having incited those students to burn their schools. These are investments into this country, into this nation, that investments that are 100 years old. And for some person, because they would like to be promoted to be the head teacher or they want promotions, they will be held personally accountable and they will be giving their story from committee prison.
We continue to do investigations to understand exactly what is the cause of what is happening.
In Nairobi, 8 students from Sunshine Secondary School were detained in Langata police station after they were arrested Friday night for attempting to burn their dormitory. Langata Police Chief Elijah Minor said that the students are under investigations and will face criminal charges Monday. Close to 100 schools have been affected in the latest wave of unrest and property worth millions of shillings destroyed, prompting President Uhuru Kenyatta to warn students against burning schools and instead seek alternative avenues to channel their grievances.
The answer is to find solutions, and you will never find solutions in destruction.
Education Cabinet Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i now says students should be involved in decision-making to try and remedy the situation.
The best way of managing our education system is through building a partnership. There's no one segment of our society that can do it alone.
Brenda Kiprono reporting for Channel One News Weekend.